Hey Gene, where's the stirrup hoe?
What?
You know the scuffle hoe?
What? We don't have that.
All right, we don't have one of those.
All right, well you guys probably know this tool, right? The scuffle hoe, the stirrup hoe, comes in different widths. These are some I did buy some really nice ones, and I never use them, and I want to talk about that today, and why that is, and what you should be doing if you want to cut back on using this tool, or have less weeds on your farm. That's really what this is about here, is having less weeds on your farm. Now, this is a very awesome tool. If you guys aren't familiar with it, it's pivoted, so it works when you push and pull the tool. It's got a very sharp, heavy-duty blade on the end, and you can cut through the weeds really well. And the reality is that I bought these and they don't get used. And let me show you, I'll talk about what I use and, you know, why I use them. All right, so this guy here, this is a collinear hoe. And I bought this from Johnny's. And this was designed by L.A. Coleman. And you can see the differences between these tools. The collinear hoe is a lot more delicate. It's a lot more accurate. It's a lot more lightweight. This one, you can really get in there and do some work with this. And so that's really the difference in the tools, but also in how they're used. Because, you know, when you have a farm where you don't have a lot of weeds, you don't really need to use this very often, because this is a very aggressive tool and can cause a lot of agitation. And I'll show you here, you know, our beds and what they look like and why this tool makes a lot more sense than this tool. But I've talked about this a lot in other videos about making sure you have a weed-free farm. And, you know, the main ways that we do that, we use a silage tarp here to kill all the weeds ahead of time, and then we build lasagna beds, and then we don't till. And we really limit the amount of weeds that are growing because of that. And I'm gonna show you some of the beds here and how we go about weeding and why, you know, the stirrup hoe has really no place on our farm. So just to show you some of these guys in use and what I mean, with the stirrup hoe here, right, you're generally leaned over and you're really pushing down to dig into the soil. And that's just not needed here. We just need a very light cultivation here. And when I use the collinear hoe, you can either go sideways. They make these in different widths too. You can also do it this way. But basically what you want to do is you just want to lightly cultivate the surface. And you can just run up and down the beds with this. But the idea here is that we're getting rid of the weeds before they even start. We're taking care of them at thread stage. We're essentially weeding when there aren't any weeds. And I know this might be a weird concept, but when you do that, you don't have weeds on your farm. So I said this before, and my old farm at Satin Hill Farm, I was running up to 29 50-foot beds, and I probably spent about an hour a month weeding. And I know that's probably crazy for a lot of you guys, and there was no weeds on my farm. So really the strategy works. It's about staying ahead of it. And also the other thing you wanna do is make sure that you are planting straight rows, because then you can easily run through there with the hoe. And let me show you another bed and how this can be worked. All right, so this is our hedgerow here, and you can see the plants are pretty far apart at this point. They haven't really grown in fully yet, but the collinear hoe, you can easily just go around the surface and get between plants. And this is with the full width of the blade. And you can see that, you know, I'm really not putting a lot of pressure on it. It's very light work, and you can just cruise around. I really just don't have the need for that heavy duty tool and having to push things, you know, hard into the ground and cut them. And I think if you can eliminate a tool in your tool shed or in your SOP or, you know, what you guys use on the farm every day, I think that's a benefit. All right, so here's a young bed of carrots, and you can see that there's no way I could cultivate this with the stirrup hoe, right? But with the collinear hoe or a really small wire weeder, you could come through here and do a really light cultivation between the rows of carrots. Now, this is not quite at the point where I do this. These are still a little bit small, but you guys can see that, you know, the kind of delicate weeding that we're talking about, you know, the stirrup hoe really has no place here, and we just don't use it. I'm gonna go cultivate this bed of onions. You'll see how quick this is. And that's it. Super quick, super simple, very effective. Well, I hope this doesn't seem like an advertisement for the collinear hoe, and that's really not what this video is about. I have no affiliation with Johnny's or the people that make that tool or anything. I just love it. But I think the point is that if you are doing really focused, precise weeding, then you're ahead of the game. And that's what I want to talk about. And that has made the stirrup hoe obsolete. Another really cool tool, which was just sent to me by a really nice gentleman named Forrest. So thank you, Forrest. This is the Mutineer from Neversink. And Neversink makes some great tools. And check it out. So this one is really cool. It's got a swappable head here. And you can put all, they sell so many different attachments. These are wire weeders. It's literally just like a piece of wire. And I got the set that has different size wires. So we're gonna play around with these. I'm really excited to put this to use. I think this might work as well, or maybe better than the stirrup hoe in different situations. It's nice because it comes with a little carabiner. You can just clip this on, swap out the heads. But again, you can see what I'm trying to get at here is, like, you know, the how delicate and how precise these tools are, because you're really just doing very focused weeding. And I've tried other things like tine rakes. I didn't really have a lot of luck with that. I didn't really like the way it worked. This has just worked really well for me. And so it's great if you can start eliminating tools in your tool shed and really focus on using less and being really efficient with them. And obviously then you have to buy less stuff. You have less stuff to maintain, less stuff to break. You know, things like that you want to be thinking about as you're determining how you want to run your farm. Well, this video has been all about the stirrup hoe and other hoes and how we use them for cultivation on the farm here. And you guys are probably interested in all the tools we're using here at the farm. And I will make a separate video about that. So look for that coming up soon. And I'll show you how minimal our tool selection is at the moment at Raleigh City Farm. I actually had to bring this tool down to the farm this morning because we don't keep it here anymore. I don't use it anymore. We don't use it on the farm. There isn't really a place for it in our system here. So I literally just brought this down here to make the video. But what I want to get at here is not really about this tool in particular, although it is about this tool, is that you want to really stay ahead of your weeds, because I've heard people say things like, oh, don't let your weeds go to seed. And I'm thinking, man, if they're going to seed, like, you messed up a long time ago. Stay ahead of it. Like, don't have any weeds on your farm. The bigger they get, the harder they are to get rid of, the more impact they have with your crops that you're growing, the worse your farm looks, your morale is down, because, you know, when you have a weedy bed or a weedy field, like, you don't want to work there. So that's not really bringing you joy as a farmer, or, you know, for marketing or people visiting your farm and all that kind of stuff. And the one thing is, if you are not wood chipping your pathways, then I think a stirrup hoe or maybe a wheel hoe would be good. And I think that's a pretty practical tool for you to use there. But we use wood chips, and some people ask me, you know, how do you hoe your walkways? And I don't, because we have wood chips in there. And they say, but you still need to hoe them. And you don't. This block's been here for over a month now, and I have not seen really any weeds in the walkways. And the reason for that is we tarp it before we build the beds, and then we build lasagna beds. So we put down cardboard and then a thick layer of wood chips. And so we really don't have weed pressure in there. And I think that's the key, is that if you plan ahead, you can take care of these things. Have some deliberate actions that you take to try to take control of your weeds ahead of time and make sure you plan ahead. And so that's why I just wanted to explain to you guys today why we don't use this tool on the farm anymore, and, you know, our strategy with weeding, and how hopefully you can take something away from this and apply it to your farm. So thanks so much for watching, guys. Make sure you hit subscribe, and we'll see you in the next one. Hey, Gene. Yo, where's the scuffle hoe?
What?
The stirrup hoe? Where is that?
What? We don't have that.
I'm laughing. You gotta be louder. Sorry, I can't do this without crack. I would never be a good actor. I can't hold it together long enough to. I'm sure you guys are probably curious about all the other tools we use and don't use on the farm. I'll make a separate video about that soon. So look